Welcome all to this painting session with me, and today we are going to demonstrate this simple landscape. So first of all, I've made the drawing already. There's not much in the drawing, just a hut and some land around it. So there's not much detail. Whatever we are going to do, most of it is going to be only with the paint. So first thing that we'll do is paint the sky. So here my brush, I'm going to dip in water, and then I'm going to take a mix of some blue colors that I have. It is Prussian blue, cobalt blue. I'll dry it on this paper. Looks good enough. Nothing fancy here, just a very light wash. Because this is not the main focus in our painting, so we will not add too many details here. You see, I've kept the paper inclined, so gravity is doing its work. The sky. Now let's add some foliage in the background. I've taken some yellow. See, when I mix, my brush already had some blue, and when I added yellow, it's already a shade of green. I could have added green, but this already makes green, so I don't need to add any more. Now I'm adding some green also. This is not very defined because we want this to, this is in the distance. So things that are far away from the viewer are not really very defined. So it's okay to have this just as sort of a pale, very ill-defined outline. For some interest, I'll some. Let's add some different shades of green here. I think I need to use less water now. Very carefully, I'll mark this boundary. Because I don't want the color to go inside this area, because this is our focal point, so this has to be very sharply painted. So I don't want any little bit of paint to come inside this. We'll keep adding the foliage here. And see, since the paper is not completely dry, the colors are mixing on their own. It's a very wonderful smoky, hazy effect. And that is the beauty of watercolors, that with very less color you can achieve very good effects. So now we're done for this part. For now, let's do this part. So I've added some cobalt blue to my sap green. You don't need to have many different colors in your palette. You can just mix colors to get the shades you want. There's no harm in buying colors, but if you are a beginner, if you are just learning and you don't know whether you are going to continue, so no need to splurge on colors. Just buy a few basic set of colors, but those colors should be of good quality because it makes a lot of difference. There is a lot of difference between student grade colors and artist grade colors. We'll just add some more foliage here and then we are done with this for now. We have to be very careful around this edge. It's already started drying. And look how smoky it feels. It looks like it's already blending in the background. And this is how things look when they are far away. They are not very defined, not very sharp. Okay. Let's add some brown also here. If I add it, I have added brown on sienna. It's already a darker shade now. You can always try on a rough scrap of paper before directly jumping onto your drawing. Let it dry. Till then, we will work on something else. Let's make this foreground. Now what we could do is, maybe there is just some ground and some grass. So let's add some yellow ochre. Oh, there's too much water. I don't want so much. This is enough. Some ochre plus some raw umber. This seems good enough. I don't have to fill all the surface continuously. Just give some random strokes. See, this is a darker color. This is sepia. Add some dash of green here. Okay. Some burnt umber. To mark off the boundary. And just some strokes to just give a feeling that this is not a very level ground. If I have some greenery here, this was wet brush on a dark paper. So see, it's such a crisp line, but this was wet on wet, so this is kind of diffused. This gives a very nice effect, and this is the speciality and beauty of watercolors. and we need to work quickly right now because we don't want very hard edges. Grass here, maybe. Okay. So let's wait. Oh, you need to be careful not to spill stray water on the paper. Okay, so while it is drying, let's go to our focal point, the heart. So since this has to be very sharp, I'll take a smaller brush now. Now let's do this. We'll use burnt sienna and some black. What does it look like? No, it's too dark. This is good. Be careful not to touch this part because this is still wet. Okay. So very carefully. Draw the outline. Actually, you could have used a slightly bigger brush because we have to cover this area. But this is okay. Can do different things with different brushes, and everyone has their favorites, so that's fine. You can achieve the same effect with different brushes. Let's add some ochre too. You don't have to cover the entire thing with thick paint, just dilute it with water and spread it. That's it. Now this side also. Okay. It's too dark. Let's add only one zena. Yes. A very light wash of the same color on the roof. It's so light that you can hardly make it out. See the contrast. The outline is so crisp now. Okay, let's wait for this to dry. Till then we'll do something else. Now what can we do here? Let's give some depth to this foliage. So we could use some, what's this? What color is this? That's acid green. I don't want that. Let's add some blue to this. Is olive green. No, I don't want that. Let's add some depth here. See, it gives the illusion of depth to this painting. This is a two-dimensional surface, but you can make it look like 3D. Darker objects are nearer, the ones that are far off are somewhat hazy and lighter in color. such a contrast, isn't it? Here also we'll do the same thing. Some blue to give it a deeper shade. The background is still slightly wet, so the color is merging. That's good. Very carefully this area. Okay. Not all the area, it's just some part behind the hut. See what a difference it makes. Make some, add some more depth here. This is some we have to be careful not to overdo things, otherwise it doesn't look natural. So I've just sparingly add a little details and then think, yes, does it look okay? Now it's too much of green, I think. Let's add some yellow ochre, because lemon yellow will be too bright. So let's add a duller shade of yellow. Now this is too dull, but it's okay. In some areas it's fine. Don't overdo. Okay, that's a yellow. Merge them so it looks better. Okay. You don't have to cover the entire area that you have painted earlier with this newer layer. This is called glazing, painting one layer over the other. So when you are glazing, you don't have to paint the entire lower layer, just some areas to give the illusion of depth. Okay, this is enough, I guess. Okay, we can add some more depth here. What a difference that makes. you just have to go with the flow in landscapes. You don't have to be very accurate with the dimensions. Say the hill can be, it's okay if the hill is like this or like that. In urban sketching, or when you're sketching people or buildings or animals or things that have specific proportions, then you have to be very careful with your drawing. But in landscapes, it's just okay, this hut should look in proportion, that's it. But it could be a little higher, it could be a little shorter, doesn't make a difference, it still looks like a hut. So that's one good thing about landscapes, that you don't need to be very very specific. Thoda unnis base is enough, that it's good enough, it's not wrong. Actually there is no right or wrong in painting, but it won't look out of place if there is some difference. Some more depth here. Okay. Add, this paint has dried now. Let's add some details here. This part is under the roof, so there is shadow here, so it's going to be darker than the rest of the part. It's going to be a bigger shadow. This one will be a thinner shadow. Be careful with your brush, okay? And again, spread it out. Just a tinge of red, it's okay. You can make mistakes, but even mistakes can look beautiful sometimes. It's okay. It's okay to make mistakes. Be more specific at the edges. This one is not sharp, so we have to wait for this to dry, otherwise it will again merge, because it will become wet edge merging in another wet edge. It won't be sharp, so let's wait for this to dry. By then we can work on this roof. Hint of the thatched or tiled structure. You don't have to make too many details, just a hint of the structure will do. It's just an illusion. We are not painting too many details, we are just giving the illusion that this is what it is. So some slanted lines. Break these lines, don't make continuous, because it looks very artificially flat. There are no straight lines in nature, everything is broken. as imperfect that is, if it's more imperfect, it sounds more, it looks more authentic, isn't it? Doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, to make mistakes. Okay. Now let's add a door. That's it. A hint of door. Let's wait for it to dry, then we'll make it darker. Okay. Okay, now what do we do? Let's wait for it to dry, then we'll make the door darker. Now this area, okay. What can we do here? Some more ground, maybe? So let's go for another brush. That one I'll go for, okay. What can we do now? Let's make some foliage. You don't paint continuous strokes with the same pressure and with the same density of color, because that will give a very flat look to the drawing, and we don't want it to be a very flat look. Yeah, there is a way to make landscapes or paintings where the colors are very flat, but that's a different type of painting. It looks beautiful, but that is not the effect that we are trying to achieve here. So we'll just make some loose strokes and get a variety of colors. See, this angle gives the illusion that this is a inclined land. It's not flat. If I had made everything flat, it would look very flat, but there is some depth here. Some foliage, just some mud. Okay. Spread it out. There is no one correct way to do things. Everything is correct as long as you enjoy the process. Nothing needs to be perfect. There is no definition of perfect. Everything is art. What is art for one may be just junk for someone else. But that doesn't matter. The aim is to enjoy the process, and for that you just need to do what you enjoy doing. That's it. Okay. Now in this area, what can we do? So maybe there's a field here, or maybe there's a water body here. This it is, hut is situated near a lake maybe. So let's paint a lake. A body of water, or maybe it's a pond in the fields, whatever. So I'm taking clean water now in my brush. Just wet this area slightly. This was completely dry till now. We'll just wet it, and let's add some blue. This is ultramarine. See, because there is some water on the paper, this is spreading the color and it gives the effect of water. Hence, there will be reflections too, because there is foliage here. It won't be completely blue. See, just a few strokes like this, and it gives the hint of reflection in the water. Edge, we should make the difference much darker. So we'll add a very sharp line and gently blend in with the lower line, because it is still wet, it will blend in, it won't look very unnatural. Can you see this? Okay. Some yellow or brown here, because there is a reflection from this side, and a very light hint of blue here, because it's just the sky. Okay. Don't have to paint everything. We need to paint all the area. This gives enough hint of. Now what can we do? Let's add some depth to the hut. It's better, doesn't it? Some detailing. Just make this edge a little sharper. Make this boundary a little sharper. We'll make this a bit darker now. Some depth here again. Okay. the detailing here. There are just some details that you can add, you may not add, but I'm just adding, they look good. No hard and fast rule. What you can do or what you cannot do. Now what can we do? Make this edge a little. This is sharper. Try not to make very straight edges because it looks very unnatural. Break the lines. Do not draw straight lines. Draw crooked lines. See, adding some little details here can add depth to the drawing. It's nothing specific that I'm doing, just these white spaces. It could be that these are some maybe stones, whatever it could be. It could be mud, it could be stone, it could be wood. It's open to interpretation. Just some black to this brown and it gives a deeper, darker tone. It immediately adds depth. Area looks a little bit empty, so maybe we could draw some branches coming down here from a tree which is somewhere here outside the field of view. So let's take some brown and mix some black, just this color. Yes, so very random strokes. hold your brush from the middle, or if you're confident, as away from the handle this part as possible, so it can, you have less control on the brush, so the lines are wilder, so to say, not controlled, and it looks more natural when we are drawing trees because the lines are not straight at all. So another branch coming this way. You can vary the pressure, and it can change pressure and direction, so it can change the width of the line, the direction, the shape of the line. Can add leaves if you want to, but I'm not going to. But I've added leaves. Thinner strokes means smaller branches. Everything doesn't have to be the same thickness. So this is enough, I think. Okay. So what else can we do here? Should we make this a little darker? It's always a very difficult decision to make, to decide when your painting is done and when you should stop making any more changes. Because as an artist, your painting may never feel complete to you. But that can only, you can only end up spoiling your painting if you do that. So you need to take a step back and assess if this looks okay. I think this looks okay for now, so let us stop. Clean your brushes, let this painting dry up completely, and then we will take out the tapes. You know why I use tapes? Because when you add water, the paper lifts up and then it changes shape, so you cannot have a flat wash if you are not putting the paper down with tapes. Okay.